Hey folks, Tom Moore, Realtor with RE/MAX Nova in Halifax, coming to you today with another driving tour. Today we are going to be doing the trip from the Halifax International Airport all the way into downtown Halifax. I'll give you a little narration on the way there, so enjoy. All right folks, here we go. We are leaving. This is the departures here on the right hand side. So. And then on the left, actually, at the start of the screen, you would have seen the Alt Hotel, which is one of the, I believe, four hotels available for people who want to have an airport hotel. Now, this is located, you know, about 40 minutes, I would say, to downtown Halifax, probably 30 to downtown Dartmouth. So it's a bit of a haul. We're just passing the parking garage as well as the arrival section here. And the U.S. departures is also to the right. You know, the Halifax Airport actually consistently wins awards for quality when it comes to you know, I guess passenger serviceability and whatnot for medium to small scale international airports. So, you know, it is a nice airport to fly through, quite frankly. We're fortunate to have it here as a gateway. The other interesting thing, now this actually varies every couple months, is the Halifax Airport, you know, it is an international airport. It doesn't have a ton of service to Europe. Last time I checked, there was a direct flight to Frankfurt, Paris, I believe London, England, and then a couple places throughout the States as well, and into the Caribbean as well. But that does vary. WestJet will service certain parts of Europe. Condor, I believe, services certain parts of Europe. But anyway, so there is accessibility with direct flights. It's probably going to be cheaper to fly into Toronto or Montreal and then do a long-haul flight from there. But, you know, if you are looking for that, I guess, quickness, the ease of access or business, then that is obviously very handy to have. So again, the Halifax Airport has, you know, they've taken a lot of effort over the last several years to keep it quite updated. So it is quite modern. There's a little, well, not so little, there's an Aerotech business park out here to the left with several aerospace companies. And yeah, so we're just gonna hop on to the highway here in a second. And you might be able to see, if you look to the left on the other side of this bridge, we got some blue sky coming out, which is great. But to the left hand side, there's actually a aviation museum, and the Halifax's Speedway is there as well. What is this guy doing? So that is, you know, if you're into car racing and whatnot, kind of a cool little thing we have here in Halifax. Okay, so I'll kind of narrate as much as I can, but you know, there's gonna be certain parts. We're a 40-minute drive here, so there's gonna be certain parts where I may not talk, and hopefully the sound of the car isn't too loud. So on the right hand side here, you're gonna see our Speedway as well as one of the other airport hotels. So there's four out here. That's got free parking with one night stay. And on the right-hand side here, we've got the Speedway. And then on the left-hand side, this is more, obviously, more of the airport. And there actually is a brand new kind of seafood export facility right there that we would have just gone by. So obviously, Nova Scotia and the Maritimes as a whole, we do quite a bit of seafood exporting here. And I believe we have pretty consistent flights to Asia, like these large, really large, just passenger jet jumbo jets. Cargo jets. They leave from Halifax. They used to leave every morning at like 3. 3 in the morning or whatever, there'd be a jumbo jet full of lobster, live fish, whatever, that would fly over to China or some of the Asian markets. I don't know if that still occurs. It was actually a big plane crash. Geez, probably 10 or 15 years ago now, where one of them crashed on takeoff, and unfortunately the whole crew passed away. But there is a you know, a healthy, I guess, seafood export business here that can be done to service international markets. So we're kind of now heading through, I don't know if you consider this Fall River, but this is kind of the outskirts of Halifax. Some might consider it Enfield, some might consider it Fall River, or even Cole Harbour. But this is kind of a bit of the boonies out here. Now, we're not super far from downtown Halifax, as you'll see on this ride, but yeah, it is a pretty simple drive. I mean, it's a divided highway all the way in, and I'll let you listen to some music here until the next little bit. To Halifax both of these ways. If you go to the right, you go towards Bedford, Sackville. The right would also take you towards, if you wanted to go to the South Shore, say Mahone Bay, Lunenburg, something like that, you go that way. And also to reach the valley, maybe Windsor or Acadia University at Wolfville, you would go that way towards the right. That exit right there is actually Fall River exit. But we're going to go to the left here, and this way will take us in through basically the back part of Dartmouth. So we'll go through Dartmouth Crossing, which is one of the large shopping districts, I guess you could call it, of the greater Halifax area, or Halifax County. And they're both those highways, so we're obviously on the left highway. You can see it's divided highway. The other side is the same. Arguably, if you're going to downtown Halifax, this way is quicker. If you're going to go to some of the kind of like back parts of Halifax, let's say Clayton Park, Fairview, Spryfield, Armdale, even the west end of Halifax, you're probably a little bit quicker to go the other way, especially for West End Halifax. West End Halifax is almost a tie. There are those two different ways to get in. But again, both of them are probably, half an hour, 40 minutes. I'm actually a little interested to see exactly how long it takes us to get to downtown Halifax here, just because, you know, there's no traffic. I think it's probably going to be closer to 30, 35 minutes. But as you can see here, as we're coming in, one thing that a lot of my friends told me when they would come visit Halifax is, you know, the airport feels like it's so far out, because as we drive through here, it's all woods and lakes on either side. There's just no development that far out to the airport. And that'll change with time. Obviously, over the next 10, 15, 20 years, the back part of Cole Harbour, which is probably more to our left, and then the back part of Dartmouth, which is more to our right, will begin to kind of roll out and you know, head towards the airport, head towards what would be Truro, and which is like another, you know, I guess, municipality that's located about an hour away from Halifax. So, oh, right, there's construction here that may slow us down a bit, but that's okay. But yeah, so like back here, it's just a lot of kind of woodlands and open land here. There's some neighborhoods off to either side, but yeah, you know, it's a simple drive, safe drive, and it's relatively quick depending on where in Halifax you're going to. Obviously in Dartmouth or Cole Harbour would be a little quicker than going to downtown Halifax. Similar story with Clayton Park or Bedford or Sackville. You know, you're just going to be a little, and those are all different neighborhoods that you would consider to be part of Halifax County. So again, I'll let us listen to some music here, and I guess I'll pick it back up when we get to Dartmouth Crossing to speak a bit more about that. Dartmouth Crossing, and this is actually Dartmouth on the other side of that lake over there. That's Lake Banook, I believe. see, I guess, the start of Dartmouth Crossing. So this is an area that has, I would consider to have the most shopping in Halifax in terms of like big box stores. So you got IKEA, you got Bass Pro Shops, or it's known as Cabela's here. You've got Kent, you've got, you know, Walmart's, Costco's. There's a lot of actually clothing stores in this place called the Villages at Dartmouth Crossing. So that's kind of like a mall that's part of the area out here, but it's designed more for like retail, whether it's furniture, clothing, you know, you name it. And then actually on the other side, so if you were to take that exit there that we just went by and keep going, you get into Burnside Industrial Park, which is obviously a really large industrial park of Halifax. It's kind of like the main industrial area. But, you know, you get the Home Depot there too. And then there's even a couple hotels out here for folks that, you know, are from the rest of the Maritimes. They'll drive here for the weekend and get all their shopping done at stores that they don't have, right? I mean, you know, you're to Sydney, you're something like 4 hours away. To Moncton, Fredericton's probably about 4 hours. Moncton's about 2.5 hours. And you've got like a bunch of other, you know, Charlottetown and Summerside are probably 3-ish hours away. So those are all kind of larger metropolises in the Maritimes. And people will literally drive here to do their shopping and try to get it all done at once. So now we're coming into like true Dartmouth here. If you were taking this exit, you'd be either heading to Pearl Harbor or another part of Dartmouth. These apartment buildings here are certainly a part of Dartmouth. This highway is a little tricky because it turns into like 110 kilometers an hour to like an actual city road up here. Yeah, so, you know, we're kind of creeping into Dartmouth here now. And if we were to go left at these lights, we get to Micmac Mall, which is another one of Dartmouth's large malls. I would say Dartmouth has some of the better shopping out of all of Halifax County. Just between Micmac Mall, you know, downtown Dartmouth doesn't have too much in the way of shopping, but it's got great walkability. And then obviously Dartmouth Crossing and Burnside, even like you got everything you need really right there. But yeah, as you can see, we're getting right into Dartmouth here, and you can actually see those condo buildings or apartment buildings way over there. Those are on the other side of the harbor. Oh, I'm going way too fast here. That's what I was talking about. You kind of get off the highway and then all of a sudden it's a 50. So you gotta watch out for the police. But yeah, we're gonna be going by Brightwood, the golf course, which I believe is a members. I used to be a member there. I believe it's still a members-only golf course, right in down, like basically in the middle of Dartmouth, right here on the left. You can see the nets for it. Great little track, 18 holes. They've got one or two holes that have this really beautiful view out over the mouth of the harbor. But yeah, so we're going to be coming in here now to kind of, I wouldn't consider this downtown Dartmouth. This is like, what would you consider it? I guess you'd call it West Dartmouth. We're going to be heading into Central Dartmouth and then crossing the bridge into downtown Halifax. So again, lots of this may seem like a strange way to get to downtown Halifax, like we're cutting through Dartmouth, but these are main arteries that we're sticking on. So, you know, it's not like you're actually cutting through people's yards or anything like that. This is one of the main ways to get to and from, you know, the peninsula of Halifax.
Driving them to school, working with them one-on-one, and keeping our classrooms healthy and clean. We're the 5,400 plus.
a big fog bank rolling across the harbor right now. So for those unfamiliar with fog, that is not an uncommon occurrence in Halifax. And I'm no meteorologist, but I believe it occurs when a cold front kind of comes in off of the ocean and collides with warmer air off of the land. I may be completely wrong. So, you know, Google that. But yeah, we do get these fog banks. And as you'll see here, it's like we're in the clouds almost. Like the clouds have kind of come down to our level here and it's put up a big wall. So unfortunately, we won't get a nice view over the harbor here, but you know, that is what it is. Now this is kind of one of the Dartmouth strip malls. We're like really very close to the bridge here. It's right in front of us. But to the left, we've got the Dartmouth Sportsplex, which is actually home to, you know, they've got a hockey rink there, a swimming pool, great slides, you know, for the kids and whatnot. They've also got a gym and a track, and then there's a little bit of shopping right around here. They've got the No Frills, which is like a discount grocer, Dollarama, bunch of other kind of shops and whatnot. So that is definitely an option if you're living in Dartmouth, and even if you're in Peninsula Halifax and you're looking for the closest discount shopping for groceries and whatnot, is probably, you're gonna have Walmart obviously in Halifax, but No Frills is certainly another option, and arguably just as cheap or cheaper than Walmart in certain cases. So something definitely worth getting is, if you're going to be commuting, is the Mac Pass, which is what I'm about to use. So you're just going to fly through the bridge like that. You don't have to stop. The computer reads the chip. And I think you save 25 cents per trip on the Mac Pass rather than paying cash. So saves time, saves some money, and there goes the fog. Look at that. Wow. So the fogs are literally like rolling banks, and sometimes they stick around and sometimes they fly out. Basically on the right hand side when I'm looking across the harbor, there's absolutely no fog, and to the left looks like I could throw a rock to a big cloud bank. So usually what will happen here is the sun will burn the fog off. So we're starting to get blue skies. It was pouring rain out earlier today, and now we're getting some blue skies, which is nice. So, you know, there is some good news in that sense. Now I'm going to take us a bit of a different way here. We'll take us the Citadel Hill way. So if I was going to go to the casino or like true downtown, I would hug the right-hand side here and circle underneath the bridge, and that would lead me into Barrington Street, basically, which is a main kind of throughfare. But this is another way that you can theoretically get to downtown. We're going to go up what's called Gottigen. So we're now in the north end of Halifax. And if you were to go straight here, you get right to the west end. Oopsie. And but, you know, if we go the Gottigen way, there's a bit more to look at, a bit more to talk about. And it still technically takes us downtown. This is just a different part. The way that we're going is the downtown way through the north end. And the way that the other way would be another 5 minutes, I would say. And that would be kind of the quickest way to get to downtown. So you would have just got on that road and would have taken you right on one street all the way to Barrington Street. So we're sitting at 25 minutes now, and we're on Peninsula Halifax. So that's pretty good, right? 25 minutes to the airport. Not too shabby. But we'll... better not go. We will... So this is North Street that we're looking at right now. And this is kind of, again, a main through fare here for getting to the bridge during rush hour. Or probably just before rush hour, maybe starting to get into it. It's 3:30 right now. So usually rush hour here is kind of, I mean, it does change, but usually like 3:30-ish till 5, if that late. Usually people kind of dip out of work a little early in my experience. So now we're on Gottingen. Gottingen Street, an area that has seen a ton of change over the last couple decades. But definitely a different part of the city. So, you know, there's not a ton of shopping down here on this end of Gottingen. As we get closer to the other side, we will. There's pizza spots, there's corner stores. And now we're getting into kind of the more artsy part. So this is, you know, a bit more hip, if you will, with different types of stores. There's craft beer projects, there's cafes, there's haircut places. There's a theater, like a small scale theater, and then you got some apartments and whatnot right here. Not too much in the way of condos. I mean, there's plenty of residential spots to purchase around here, but yeah, there's not a ton of condos. I guess you could go literally a block in any direction, you find condos. Again, more just kind of shops and whatnot. Let this lady go. There's a cool... So, right on my left here is called the LF Bakery. Very kind of like a local, really good spot. I think that the baker is actually from France. And then also on the left, the Seahorse Tavern, very famous old bar. They've got some great shows there at the Marquee Ballroom and Seahorse Tavern. And then right here to the left as well, another shout out to Seven Bays Cafe, which is also a bouldering wall. Anyways, really cool spot to grab a coffee, get a beer. And there is rock climbing or bouldering there. So it's not like you hook into harnesses or anything. But yeah, there's, and again, within like probably 3 blocks from here, there's probably 4 craft breweries. So like, this is kind of part of the more artsy kind of hip part of the city, and this is what I would consider to be the border of the North End, which we're sitting on right now. We're about to cross over into downtown, or the downtown core. On the right hand side, just for people wondering, that's Centennial Pool, which is a large pool right there. This is the police station on the left, and then Citadel Hill right smack dab in front of us. So we're going to kind of come in at downtown from the top and show a little bit of it. So you can see the Scotiabank Center, which is where all the large concerts, the Halifax Mooseheads, Halifax Thunderbirds sports teams play there. And in the background, there was, you might have seen the big glass building with BMO on it. That's actually the convention center, which we will end up driving by here soon. Oh, I feel like it's getting sunny out. Really not so nice out earlier today, and now it's starting to get nicer. A couple bars on the left here, Halifax Sports Bar and Grill. Great place to watch the games, a little bit expensive on the beer. And then the Halifax Ale House, which is a very famous old bar in Halifax. So they have good live music usually when it's going. They had an incident there, geez, in the winter or summer, where one of the bouncers actually killed, But now it's at trial right now, but he killed one of the patrons. So I think that the alehouse is off the... It's not the same as it is it once was, but who knows what will happen with a little bit of time. But the alehouse used to be a really great spot to check out. I haven't been there since the incident, so can't really speak to what's going on there now. Up here on the right with this fence is the old... Well, it's the old officer's mess, and it's like a military kind of parade ground. And then, oh, this big glass building on the left here is the Halifax Convention Center. So now we're in kind of really getting into downtown Halifax here. Again, there's lots of hotels around here. Gahan House on the left, great bar, and Dirty Nelly's also on the left, which is a really famous Irish pub, or Halifax famous, I should say. Is this open? Yep. Okay. And then this is the Neptune Theater, which is kind of our main play area. So, you know, all of our big theater productions will be there. And the Pint on the left. This is like a great little bar street here, called the Argyle, or Argyle Street, I should say. Pete's Corner just to our right. And yeah, that's about it, folks. We are smack dab in the middle of downtown. We're on the corner of Blowers Street and Barrington. And I'm going to sign off now. So everybody, I hope this is helpful for people that maybe are going to be doing the drive-in or whatever. And once again, love to see you guys subscribe. Let me know how to improve these in the future, and have a great day.